Hello everybody, I'm Sanjeev from Department of Physics, Government College, Rajahmundry, India. In this video, I would like to discuss about the working principle of a parallel plate capacitor. So capacitor stores energy in the form of electric charge. And for storing electric charges, I'm taking metal because it allows free movement of charge carriers compared to insulators and semiconductors. So here I took a metal plate. This is a side view of it. I'm trying to store charges on this. So for that purpose I'm taking a battery and I'm connecting positive terminal of the battery to this plate. So what happens? So positive charge carriers from the battery will move on to the plate and get stored on it. So here one charge got deposited or stored on the plate, metal plate. So now what happens to the second charge? When it reaches the plate, it gets a repulsive force from the first charge. So to overcome that, I need to apply more potential, or I need to push the second charge to keep it along with the first charge. And like that, I may be able to store a few charges on this plate. So the capacity of the material is defined as, our capacity of the material is proportional to charge. So if the material is able to store more amount of charge, we can say the material has more capacity. Or if I need less potential, let's say I'm applying 1.5 volts here to store 5 charges or 10 charges on the plate. So now, how to improve this capacity? So to do that, I'm introducing another plate parallel to this. So what happens if I introduce another metal plate parallel to existing plate? So there negative charges will be induced because this plate is completely positively charged. Positive ions will exist because of the charge. So this plate will be negatively charged. And on the opposite side, positive ions will be induced because these two charges are induced, negative charge and positive charge, both are induced, whereas here all these positive charges have come because of charging through this battery. So what happens then? Because of this negative charge, I'm creating a diversion for these positive charges. Instead of fighting among themselves, repelling among themselves, these positive charges got some another work of inducing these negative charges. So instead of 1.5 volts, now I can store these 10 charges at 1 volt itself, let's say. So now I want to improve it further. So I'm connecting another wire from the other end of the second plate to the negative terminal of the battery. What happens then? These positive charges will be absorbed by the battery. So what happens? I'll be left with only negative charges on the second plate. So these negative charges will be effectively diverting these positive charges on the first plate. So now I can store these 10 charges even at lesser potential by applying less potential. Instead of 1 volt, now I can store them by using 0.5 volts, let's say. So the capacity improved by this extra connection. So capacity of a single plate improved by the introduction of second plate itself, and it is further improved if I connect the second plate to the negative terminal of the battery. So now I can improve the capacity by increasing the area of the plate. So more the area, more charges can be stored, and by reducing the separation between these two plates. If I reduce the separation, these negative ions can produce a diverting field for these positive ions. They can effectively divert these positive ions from fighting among themselves or repelling among themselves. So capacity improves even further. But there is a limit on this suppression. We can't bring it too close or make it zero, because after certain distance these charges may fly over and reach the positive charges, gets neutralized. So that point is called breakdown of the capacitor. So when the distance between the two plates is too low, these ions will fly over and reach the positive ions and system neutralizes. So that's called breakdown of the capacitor. So now, if I still want to improve the capacitance, what to do? I'm introducing a dielectric material. It is a pure insulating material. So what happens then? On one side, there will be negative ions induced because of the positive ions on the first plate. And on the other side, positive ions will be induced because of the negative ions on the second plate. So now, what happens? Effectively, the separation between positive and negative ions. So let's say this distance is 10 centimeters. In the earlier case, these positive ions see a negative ion or negative charge at a distance of 10 centimeters. Now this distance is reduced to 1 centimeter. So in other words, the capacitance is improved by 10 times because of the reduction in effective distance. So I can write this as, this epsilon naught is the permittivity of the medium. Here it is permittivity of the vacuum or air. With the introduction of dielectric, the permittivity term is now replaced by this. And this is called relative permittivity. So if the effective distance reduces by 10 times, I can say the capacity improved by 10 times, or the relative permittivity is 10. So compared to vacuum capacitance or free air capacitance, now the capacitance improved by 10 times, I can represent that number 10 as relative permittivity of the dielectric medium. So here the advantage is, even if these charges come too close, almost 10 times closer to the earlier case, these charges cannot come out and merge with these positive ions, positive charges, because the material is dielectric material. It is an insulating material. So at most we can induce the charges on this, but we can't remove these charges. Of course, still there is a breakdown point even for this dielectric material, but compared to air and vacuum, this is very high. So that's why we're able to come this closer, almost 10 times or even more for some materials. Still, the charges will not be able to merge together. So that's how I'm able to improve the capacitance. Now, so this is from the point of view of parallel plates. So how to improve capacitance by increasing the area of cross section, area of the plate, or separation between the plates, or the relative permittivity of the dielectric medium. If I see from the point of view of charges, I have to talk in terms of fields instead of potentials, because I need to be more specific about the direction of charges. Then I can represent the electric field by negative gradient of potential. Is then the macroscopic field is given by this. Macroscopic field, E naught is the applied field by the battery, and P is the polarizing field or induced field on the dielectric material. So the effective field, macroscopic field, reduces by this term, P by 3 epsilon naught. Or if you see inside the material, inside the dielectric material, the field is given by local field inside the dielectric material is E naught plus P by 3 epsilon naught. So this dielectric material reduces the effective field, that implies effective potential and capacitance improves. In other words, it reduces the effective distance between the positive and negative charges. That's how a dielectric works or improves the capacitance. So this is the working principle of a parallel plate capacitor. Thank you.